I'm not an Elizabeth Gilbert or anything. I haven't cut a money deal, but I'll have reached my own personal definition of success, which is what I'm doing now. And I'm a recovering child of narcissistic abuse at 60. And what it is like being in a relationship with a pathological narcissist is that they are conflict-oriented and conflict-driven, but also conflict-centric. Everything's a conflict. You can't actually have a conversation with them. A narcissistically abusive relationship will deplete you of life force energy. It could kill you. After being drained of their life force by these partners. And also, let me just talk about what was absent in all of those relationships, as opposed to what was in them. Affection, your attention, your acknowledgement. So that was absent in every single one of my relationships. I've gotten to the point now where it's actually kind of funny, and I can actually probably create a comedic stand-up sketch about it. I mean, the creativity and the things that one can do once you're released from having to always put energy into a relationship that is sinking. It's a sinking ship. There is no relationship with a narcissist. You're in it all by yourself. That's the irony. I realize also that I am not ready for a partner because I'm actually partnering with myself. But I even became less ready for a partner when I realized the idea of growing with another person, of having a man in my life that was interested in growing as a spirit, who also understood what the three A's are, that received them well, and understood that all things, all living things, plants, children, pets, people, women. So why was I treated so badly in all my relationships? Well, many of you know, but many of you don't know. And I will reiterate, when you were raised by a pathologically narcissistic parent, in this case, my mother, with an absent father, you had absolutely no attention given to you at all. And there. And what it is like being in a relationship with a pathological narcissist is that they are conflict-oriented and conflict-driven, but also conflict-centric. Everything's a conflict. You can't actually have a conversation with them. Every soul thrives. Every spirit thrives in their incarnation with the three A's. Affection, acknowledgement, and attention. If you were to say, honey, you know, I'd really like it if you would like come home at least in a more positive mood. I'm gonna give you some time to yourself, but please do not lash out at me. Go work out. And that's met with like hatred, anger, the cold shoulder treatment. Raising two little babies, and he says to me, you get to stay home with the kids all day while I have to go to work. It was just that he was giving me shit about staying at home, and it really hurt to never be appreciated. That's emotional abuse. You bore two children naturally, 17 and a half months apart. You're the stay-at-home mom. You are living in a town with absolutely nobody that you know. You left Tucson, Arizona to follow his job. You left your program to be a paralegal, to follow his dream to be with IBM and do some sort of computer shit. And along come baby one, baby two, and then your dreams are over. They're dashed. And he tells you, you're lucky. You get to stay at home and do nothing. while you're nursing nonstop, changing diapers, entertaining babies, doing nothing. He wishes he could stay home and do nothing. And so I was like, okay, well, I guess that means I have to get a job, huh? I went through the idea that I could actually find a person online dating that was at a consciousness level that met mine, and boy, was I wrong. And went through some gloomy feelings about that until I recognized that my desire to have a partnership is really strong in my natal chart, because I shine in a relationship and I help my partner shine. But there's another aspect, because it's my seventh house facing my first house of the South, and seventh being partnerships in one-on-one, it's showing me how really getting to know the South, the self, S-E-L-F, small s and capital S-E-L-F, is what I have the opportunity to do right now. That's why I'm not in a partner seeking mode. And the universe supplied me with all the doinks on online dating that you could possibly have, that made it quite blatant to me that it was really all about sex. But also, I am at a different consciousness level in which sex is what you do after you've been met in all the other places that are a requirement for me to have a satisfying relationship. I have to understand the man, and he has to understand me. We have to get each other. In the heart level, mind level, and the spiritual connection, and then the sex comes easy. But these guys wanted to go straight for the finish line. They wanted to go straight for the sex. And I go, oh, okay, my consciousness level is higher. I'm the wise woman, I'm 60. I can teach women how to hold off their urges, because biology and mother nature and hormones, I know what it's like to want to hump everything in sight. Oh my God, I do. Every soul thrives, every spirit thrives in their incarnation with the three A's: affection, acknowledgement, and attention. Affection, your attention, your acknowledgement. So that was absent in every single one of my relationships. Live your life, girls, for you. But men do not value you online. You're just a piece of meat. You're next. You're a conveyor belt of pussy. Different stages of like when they can get in to your orifice, to your beautiful, precious palace. Do not give away the jewels. And so what I learned from the online dating experience is that they only relate to you as a sexual object. Men have really become opportunists, and I'm talking about the majority of them. It's really utilized and viewed as a way to get sex as soon as possible. Mm-hmm. And for men, that's under 3 dates or less than 2 weeks. So this woman, I was on it for all the wrong reasons. The right ones for myself, the wrong ones for the platform. So I got off the platform. Cheers to that. So any woman who's really looking for a life partner, the best thing to do is to not look for the life partner, but let the life partner find you. By doing the life that you want and enjoying yourself. It's really utilized and viewed as a way to get sex as soon as possible. Mm-hmm. And for men, that's under 3 dates or less than 2 weeks. Oh, my blessings, I'm so lucky. I get to be me now. And to be able to go, wow, I know there's light. I know there's something more than this. But there's myself.
where everyone is rocking around saying, give everyone a chance. It's give them a chance. You just end up becoming the smartest person in the room. You're like, yeah, no, I'm not giving them a chance. You become smart. You become savvy. Yeah, a lot of people are going to say, what's your story? Why aren't you just going along with it? Because you're never just going to go along with it again. Give yourself permission to cut the sandbags off. Let yourself soar high. Once you get that distance from the narcissist, I promise you, it's going to be like you lost 300 pounds overnight. You will feel as light as air. It takes time. It doesn't happen overnight. But even if you can't get out of this relationship, please make a commitment to yourself, that at some level, day by day, brick by brick, you're going to allow your potential to shine.